Well, it's been hard work. You might just struggle with some of the conditions. Finally paid off.
It's alright, I'm going to end up editing for hours anyway, aren't I?
He managed to edit about 15 hours of filming down to around 5 minutes.
Because that's all I could use.
Well, how are you doing, boys?
Good lad. See, I
knew it.
That's where you haven't slept properly, mate, and all the travelling and that.
He's got a headache as well, apparently. I can't think why.
Cookie, you're going to be burned out in about 2 hours' time. You know that, didn't you? I can do it. I can do. No, you can't, Cookie.
Let's just realise the coffee's going to be rocking for you.
Oh, he'll be alright then. He'll be like,
9 o'clock, he's gonna be like, yeah.
He'll survive, I'm sure.
Yeah.
You don't want to go on middle for that.
Exactly. He'll turn up in the day, he'll come on me. No.
Yeah, in the very last one.
No, these are kind of
the most prized that we've got,
and
then
I think
that
we have a late time to have them all
right. Work out nice.
Everyone can be fairly close without being on top of each other, right?
I won't be on top of you. You won't walk.
Won't be on top of you, would it?
Just having a right nice sleep as well. Right nice.
So have you got a puffy area of cord,
man? No longer. It's right at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? Hold on.
You're recording already.
It records everything, bro.
It's recording already.
I just leave it recording, man. You've got to get all the beginning bit where everyone's getting together. And I know there's going to be lots of editing needed already. His swearing's been non-stop.
That's what I was going to say. Camcorder's over there.
Just a professional.
I brought my.
I'm hoping, mate, I got one of them pegs there because I will cast from the tent.
You'd just be sitting there with the kids in bed.
It's alright.
And all you see if his alarm's gone off, so you're running down the hill like.
He'd be running, he'd be rolling down it like.
My tent is happy, mate.
Is it warm?
Alright, yeah.
Yeah, I was puckered last night, I was.
Decent inside, no problems with
it. As you can hear is Henry.
Yeah, waking up here. That smile then realised I've got his food bag next to me. Garlic.
Oh, the old the curries or whatever he's got, some Thai stuff in there. So he's got.
I'm staying away from the camera!
Hold on, I'm going to be editing for weeks, it's alright. This video will be ready for next year, just about.
You might want to mix them up, someone looks at each one. You can leave number 4 there though.
The four's the other side.
That's alright,
just you have to move the pot.
The other side of the bridge.
You have to move it, it's the other side of the bridge, mate.
I think you're gonna end up with
9 or 20. Oh, that's I said you realise I'm gonna salt and fish at the same time.
Listen, I will explain. People want once they pick this one, if they want to swap with someone, they want to swap with the okay.
You still want to fish with me, boy, you're not
gonna
let
them.
Makes no answer to me, like.
Listen, you wanna fish with me?
Yeah. As long as everyone's happy, it'll be cool, like I'm not worried. Doesn't, you know what I mean?
I'll be honest, swim sort of 3 to 5, I'll even swap me missus for, let alone swim. Well, you know. I mean, I don't need it till Sunday anyway. Is the camera still on?
That's on. Yeah. Don't edit that.
Hold on.
All right, morning everyone.
Morning.
Good
morning.
Morning. Morning. Morning.
Finished at 5, because someone said they were going to get up at 5.
I was up.
He was up at 5.
You weren't here at 5. I didn't say I'd be here.
Yeah. Now, girls.
Bitch. Yeah. Wow. Right. Welcome, everyone, to Wylands and the second Mossy match. Peg-wise, we're going to do a draw for the pegs. I know some people, you know, once we've done the draw, may want to move about. If you do want to swap with someone and the person that is happy enough to swap, I've got no problem with it, you know what I mean? As long as everyone's happy. You know, and settled. It's no stress with it, so it's all good. The pegs are marked out. There's quite a bit of space, hopefully, for everyone to be happy with whatever peg they get. It's going to be a random draw. The way I'm going to do the draw is as the tickets were bought. Number one draw, Rob will get that because he's defending champion anyway. So you'll be out of pick first, but then literally as the tickets were bought, I'll call out the names and you just take a key ring. You'll have a number. And then you've got a couple of hours to go and get yourself settled and sorted. So it's pretty stress-free, hopefully. There is meant to be some rain, I think some people will know, coming on at some point, but it's meant to be later on this afternoon, so hopefully everyone will be all sorted and can hide away if need be. Apart from that, there's going to be a few of us that will be walking around Marshy and me, Cookie, I think there'll be a couple of others. Any fish you catch or whatever, just give someone a shout, we'll come round, we'll weigh it. and we'll sort that out. So everything's taken care of, it'll be roped down, and it's literally the biggest fish. There's no accumulated weights or anything like that. It's not a match style, it's just literally anyone can win it with having a bit of luck and catching the biggest fish. So apart from that, I think we're pretty much ready to go. Does anyone need to know anything or feel they want to know anything? Oh, one thing. If anyone's thinking of fish, floater fishing, surface fishing, anything like that, it is allowed, but we're not going to allow any freebies thrown out over the top. Just purely for the sake of it moving down over other people's swims or drawing them up off the top where other people are fishing. It's not something that I would have thought about, but I know they do the carp leagues down here. And it was something that was brought up, so I think it's only fair. If you want to float on top, it's fine, but just obviously plug your hook bait or whatever, single hook bait, no chucking 900 gosh biscuits out.
What's the rules on netting? So tracing myself for fishing as a team?
Yep.
So if she gets a fish on, can I net it for her?
What, do exactly what you want, as long as it's safe for the fish and everyone's at it, it's no problem. You do what you want to do, it's brilliant, it's no problem. Like I say, as soon as you do have one, hopefully one of us will be around to come and help you, then weigh it and just make sure everything goes fine, right? So, no, it's all good. Because you're working as a team as well, two rods in there,
yeah.
Whether you want to strike or whether you want to take it, it's down to you, it works as you want, it's fine. Are we all good with that? Everyone fine, yeah?
Yeah.
It's been like a nice day as well, so. Mr. Moss, yeah. You want to take the key ring, sir? Literally, they're mixed up, so just pick one and then find your swim.
Seven.
All right, as it works, I will be in number one, but I'm not fishing, so don't think I've picked it because I know it's a going swim, because it's not the case. It's just purely so I'm in between both lakes.
Seven's over there.
So yeah, it works clockwise on here, so 2, 3, 4, 5, I think you'll find you're on the other side over there. And then we've got 13 to 20 is on middle lake on the other side. Right?
Nice.
Keep it with you, mate. Sure, just keep hold of it. Yeah. Yeah. So.
Over the back.
1, 2.
It worked out. Although I planned to do 30 pegs, it's actually with the number we've got, it's actually brilliant.
How many on middle?
There's 8 pegs on middle. 13 to 20, so it's not too bad. I mean, some of you obviously fish it, so you're going to know maybe some of the going spots and all that, but
you know, see how you go. 2 or 3.
Right, Yoda. Second pick, mate.
Right there.
Not that one. Middle.
15, Yoda guy. Mr. Beardmore.
Just before the drain.
Yeah,
that's over there as well. So this
17, the other side of the outlet.
Neil
Calder. 17. Three.
Sorry,
Roy.
Tracy.
No. Sorry, mate.
Yeah, but
oh,
yeah, so whoever wants to pick it.
I don't need it for Sunday.
Yeah. 18.
18. Okay, lovely.
Not that far away.
Tight. What else we got here? Yeah, Becky, you're next. Do you want to come up?
16.
Yeah, cool.
16.
Oh,
that ain't too bad. I'll figure that out. Bruce.
Pass it to your pick. Where are you?
Number 5. Roy.
What number did you get?
5.
It
would be funny, yeah, wouldn't it?
What, 20?
Well. Right. I know.
I'll pick it.
Go on in, Joshua. But remember what happened.
Number 20, Joshua.
Yeah, 20, Josh. Come on, Josh.
20. Choose one. It don't matter which one you pick, mate.
If I get 20, I'm going to kill myself.
No, you're not.
Sometime this week.
Let's go again.
12.
Oh, in the middle.
Lewis.
I don't want a cameraman next to me.
Mr. Lee. Brian,
you fished well, mate.
Yeah.
Go on,
mate.
Ten.
Look, you fished well.
What numbers did you get?
18, 16. You're here, isn't
it? Alright, cool. Well, I think I've picked out quite a left swing. Sorry, no worries. So what I might be able to do is put you together because you're in a bit where you might get a room.
That would be good. That would be good. That would be good baggage if you could, mate.
It's never a problem.
Mark.
Sir? Roy.
Del.
Come on, son.
Pick him a winner. Be a good one.
11.
Three. Last one.
We're on the same lake.
Martin.
I'm never
going to Mr. Brown.
Four. Mr. Jeremy.
Is it?
Yeah. 20.
20.
20.
20.
Yeah. Yes. Right down the bottom. Right in the corner.
Anthony.
Set.
The very last one. Kev's
picking it.
34. Against the reeds. First.
In the middle.
Harry?
Go on then.
The match is going to start about 9 o'clock, people, so you've got an hour and a half or so to take your time. Yeah, if everyone goes to their swim, it's like our first all season.
Whoever's in between you,
What are you?
17.
Who got 17? I don't know, we'll find out. I mean,
Who got 17? Do you want to swap with one of these so they can go together? You're in the middle of them. So you can either go
lower
or higher.
I'm going to get that maybe made longer, because I'm going to do three on each side. Once we get to the 10th year, I'll let you
go down another one.
And then I'll get another one.
What is the time? So it's 8:30. Saturday morning, half hour before the Mossy match starts. Pegs have been chosen and this is going to annoy everyone.
Hi.
You all set? All sorted? It looks alright, you're up, aren't you? You got your bits in there? Can I get this in the... Oh, don't quite fit, it's too large, but we'll get a bigger one later.
Move from the other side.
Yeah, I will do. I'm going to walk round everyone's pegs now. So Nigel is in swim two. I'm swim one, but I'm not fishing. Base camp only. Like I say, we've done a peg draw. Everyone's happy, settled. The actual numbers I was thinking of getting on these two lakes was going to be way too many, and what we have got here is perfect. Mr. Calder,
right.
How are we doing?
Yeah, lovely, mate. Just going to get the witness skin on. Just go for the sauce to chuck down.
What did you get? Swim three, didn't you?
Yes.
Four? Three?
Three. Very happy.
Oh, there's a big fish just jumped in yours as well, yeah. Right in front. So.
Lovely, lovely.
So, Mr. Calder is in three, which is there, and he's sorting himself out. So, we'll go and bother him. Cookie and others gone to the efforts, like I say, you got the 2-2-2 there in the grass and Mossy. Excellent. Real good stuff. So we'll take a tour. We'll visit everyone. So you've seen Neil already, but what? You're all done and ready to go?
Yeah, just about ready, mate. Not long till we're off now, is it?
About half hour, mate, so we'll try and quickly get round with the camera and then we'll get on with it. So, got the bridge. So I think it's Mark Oliver is in here. I know he's just gone up the snack bar. So this is swim number 4. They've got the bridge and bits and bobs. Looks like he's all sorted. Got some scales out. Ooh, easy. So, because of the numbers we have got, which is 20 altogether, it's actually worked out really well to give everyone a bit of water. And it's actually probably exactly the right amount to have on these lakes. Because it kind of keeps everyone happy. So there's a bit of a gap here between that swim there, number 4 mark, and then number 5. Is this swim 5? Yeah. Swim 5, Mr. McKay. Mr. Rubble. You all right?
Yeah, okay.
Everything sorted, mate?
Yeah, all sorted.
Oh, Mr. Lewis, who's down in 6, which is down the end there. We're going to come down and annoy you next. I'm doing a lap before I start everything, so just get everything on camera. Yeah, you got everything, Barney. Yeah, you all right? Yeah, you cool, mate? So number 5, and then another missed swim. So like I say, it has worked out nice, the numbers, to give everyone some room. Lewis has got like your little bivvy and your little bits, and you got like the biggest swim in the world. You know that, didn't you? So this is the end swim on this bank, number 6. Quite a nice view. Seen any fish down here, mate?
Yeah, good.
Yeah, down in the corners here. Yeah. Like I say, I am told when it gets pressured up one end, they just come down here. So you might be in with a few, like. Not sure how big they'll be, but it's, you know, they're meant to go to mid-20s and that, so yeah. So there's some good fish about. There's a few jumping in the middle down there. Oh, he's letting about. Shall I have a go at him? Not really. Should wait for the whistle. I'll have a little chat quick. I'm going to have a fight with him now. Right, Lewis, I'll catch up with you in a bit, yeah? Wait, get that rod out of the water, you. All right. I've told everyone they're not allowed to lead about.
Oh, right, okay.
And as soon as the whistle goes, mate, we do, you know. But I didn't see none of that, nor did the camera. Right, so, done number 6. Now we're going to walk round the corner. You can spy on Lewis from here. walk round the corner. And round the corner, I think, in the first swim round here, is the defending champion. I think that's how it worked out. All a bit of a blur. I didn't write none of the names down, but we will be going around with some sheets. In a bit, put everyone's name down, what peg they're in. Yeah, so this is House Lake. This is where the peg started, basically. And then it goes round to Middle Lake, which we'll get to if I can do it all in the time permitted. Literally starts in 20 odd minutes, so I'm pretty sure no entry. Who's that? It's Donnie, defending champion. So you got peg 7, didn't you?
Yeah.
It's quite narrow, but you got the hole there, haven't you? And under the bridge and that, there's a bit of water there.
Should be alright. Yeah.
Yeah, like I say, yesterday when we pegged them out, they were down here. And what, Mummy's bringing teas round, is it?
Mummy's boy.
Talk about spoil.
Well, what's that say?
Mama raised no fool.
Who's the fool? That's what I'm worried about, you know? Oh, cool. You're all sorted, are you, mate? Got your bits, well.
Yeah, I'll do that after.
Yeah?
Just getting this lot
sorted. That's what Mum's
come across to. Oh. Mum, set it all up for me, put it all in there, please.
Doing anyway.
Yes, she's put it up more times than you have.
Oh, yeah, true.
Yeah.
That is true.
Put that video up more times than
you have. Right, I'm walking around because I ain't got long before we start, so I'll let you crack on. Yeah. You might as well let your mum fish instead, eh? And you go and sit in the camper or whatever. Yeah. I'll catch up with you later. So, the Moss family, Rob, Don, Steve is in the motorhome still, I believe. Who have we got here? Yes. It's Richie B.
Yes.
How are we doing, sir?
I'm okay, I've swapped swimmers with Barry.
Yeah, you switched over, yeah?
Yeah, well, he's got two man bivvy, it wouldn't have gone on here. Oh,
okay, fair enough, yeah, no.
See the position of the rods?
What's going on here? you've had to manoeuvre.
Yeah.
I like it, alright, so fishing a little bit down the snag side there, down the margin.
Over there to start with.
Oh, okay.
Let's see how it goes.
It's alright. As long as everyone's happy, you're all cool with where you are.
Just getting things ready to go.
Oh, there's the good luck charm there, look. On the phone. Is that on the phone there, playing around?
Yeah, playing.
Oh dear, she don't. Oh, Angry Birds. So what swims we here? What is it? Eight and nine. All right, so you did have each other's swim, but you've swapped over, yeah?
Yeah.
Nah, that's cool. It's all good.
Yeah. Also, good. I know the old frostbite works over there, you see.
Oh, look. Yes. Oh, he's done you up there.
He
could have lent you his bivvy, but no. He thought he'd nick your swim instead. Yeah. What's that? They're Armo, isn't it?
Yeah,
two men?
Yes.
You know that, that's what I've got.
Well,
got
well
good luck,
comfort.
Lads. Yeah, we ain't got long, have we? So
I've got about 15, 20 minutes, I think.
Alright, I'll be round again. Who's in this one? Mr. Collins. How are we doing, pal?
Okay, mate, thanks.
Good, good. I'm going to come and annoy you with a camera. Oh, I'm trying to get a bit of video in before we start. Whatever, mate. Don't matter. 10, number 10. Got ideas, got plans, have you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Peg I wanted.
Yeah? Oh, you've done all right then.
I've done well on these two pegs.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right. Oh, that sounds promising, mate. I'm expecting good things from you now.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Fingers crossed.
Yeah, good stuff.
Wind's in the right direction.
Well, it's pushing across nice, isn't it?
I'm only here for the crack, you know?
That's what everyone's here for,
just
mate.
Just to meet everyone and enjoy
mate.
It.
Exactly that. We all want to have a fish, as long as people are catching, but like you say, it's about all coming together and enjoying the weekend.
Yeah, it's brilliant, it's so friendly,
no.
Everyone.
Yeah, it's been good, isn't it? Already yeah. It's been good. And I actually weren't as nervous as I thought I was going to be this morning, so I feel pretty good about it so far. So,
catch you later,
good luck, mate, yeah? Bye. I'll see you later on. Who's in the next swim? Who's in this one? Who's down there? Oh, might be some editing going on as I get closer to Roy by the seams of it. Who's in 11? We don't know. They're obviously not here at the minute. We'll have to catch up later on with 11. Ducks. They're taking obviously this swim. Right. I can see me, as we walk round here, I can see the beeping being put in at some point in this video. It's getting a bit windy as well. But swim 12, the only one on this bank, and out the way of everyone kind of thing. He's Mr. Lawler, who I'll be very surprised if he misses concert. I've already heard you over there, so I know I'm going to be doing loads of editing, so it's all good. Where are you, Del? Are you in 11? Yeah. No, you are, mate. Right, I was down there. I was like, who's in there? Who's in there? No one's in there. Yeah, no, it's cool. Yeah, you look sorted, so that's all good. Is it? Yeah. Oh, that's cool, mate. Good stuff. Yeah, cool, mate. Like I say, we've got, what we got, 20 minutes or so? I'm trying to do a video of everyone sort of in their swims before I... You got the air on with you? And I don't mean Rose, don't, you know, normally that's just the quick comment, the yeah.
It's in the tent underneath.
Okay, mate.
So you just got a...
What, in the barbecue tent?
In the barbecue tent.
Okay, mate, I'll sort that out. Yeah, well, I'm sure it will be. Everything's gone well so far, everyone's happy. Right. Weather's alright, I mean, it ain't raining as yet.
We might pop a bit, but...
Yeah, I think we'll get a little bit.
We'll do alright, mate.
Well, like I say, everyone's got plenty of time to get sorted and...
I'm in no rush.
It's not going to make no odds. Yeah, it's enough hours to sit back, isn't it? I know Lewis in the corner, he'll play you up and won't put his words out for about 5 hours or so. It's just what he does.
I
normally
do that
down there.
I get abused for that.
No, 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 no.
But Lewis is doing it.
Lewis does it for a reason. He doesn't come down, put the BV up, and don't put the rods out ever. What do you mean, shush? This is the normal Crusader family you know.
He's giving everybody else a chance.
Oh, yeah.
Have you noticed the way everyone regularly is going, if I put his rods out?
You notice how shocked they are when, yes, you've actually, when you bring a rod case down, or, you know. Has he got alarms on that pod?
No. I think Cookie's got them. I'm trying to think when
we dealt up. Oh my god.
Please not
to my delts, right, look, I've got 15 minutes, this is too much. I know there'll be too much editing for me to do, so lads, I'll catch up with you soon, alright? Right, so that was swim 12. That was House Lake. So there's a driveway. House Lake. Middle Lake. So swims 13 to 20. Although I did do a slight mess up because we had one more person I didn't put a peg out for, but it's been sorted because they're actually fishing together, so luckily we had the room and it's not, there's no stress. So number 13, unlucky for some, but actually a pretty good peg. Are you in there? No, he's hiding, he's down the way somewhere before we start. Anthony Downs, I believe. So, yeah. Number 14 is Peter Lee. I don't know if he's in there. No, he's wandering around. I have seen him about. 15 is Yoda. Yoda, Yoda. Everything cool?
Everything's cool, sorted.
You all good? About 10, 15 minutes, mate. Got a big air on that Roy has bought, so we'll whack that at some point. Just doing a bit of video of everyone in their pegs and walking around and just before it all. Oh, hold on, hold on, hold on. What are you smiling for? Whose is this, Yoda? Whose is it? Why are you saying it like and walking away? Professional style going on here.
That's a nice peg over there.
That is the number 20. A lot of people like say that's a good peg. So
hacking in there, it's got all of that to it as well.
But it's all about big fish, not a mountain of fish. I know. Kev, I think, took £183 from there the other week in Carp. But you can do it. You can do this. Right, let's see Mr. Beardmore. And what you done?
You're all right, mate.
Hello, baby.
Oh, mate.
He didn't even want to look at the camera then, did you? I was shy. Oh, my word. cookie saying I'm shy. That's just not right. What are you up to?
Not a lot, mate. Just getting ready. Pretty much done now. Getting
What's this? A few tactics.
What's this?
Top secret. I know what it is.
I know what it is, though.
Yeah.
From your nice new mate.
Yes.
He's a nice lad, isn't he?
Gentleman and a scholar.
There's the main man. This is the one we all want to worry about, because this one's going to win it. I can feel it.
Yeah.
You're going to show you how to catch some fish, this one, aren't you? Yeah? You're going to make sure you beat your dad. That's all that matters. All right? Good stuff. Good stuff. All right.
We'll win it.
Are you sleeping in there with your dad as well, yeah?
No.
No? No, you're just going to do the day? All right, see how you go, innit? Ian Harper will be down later. Because he was the one that was chosen, wasn't it, to have a free ticket, and he's going to bring you some bait in now, I think, as well. Yeah, don't let your dad have any of it.
Yeah,
all right, keep it to yourself. Right, I'm big deep breath there. Don't go near me, Rod. I'm going to walk round because we've got about. Air on that I hope is going to work.
I don't want to be really cracked. Don't quite impressed with that. Ain't you fishing? Yeah. Yeah, when you're ready. Yes, mate, yeah. I'm quite impressed with that. I want to play a bit now. Yeah. Right, cool.
Go away from me or we're in.
18.
How big?
18.
18? You're taking libbies?
Yeah. I think I'll go home then.
Well, I told you you weren't allowed to catch if you come down. So, first carp of the match, is it?
Yes, mate.
Mr. Calder.
What, 18 on the nose?
18 pounds, yeah. Look at his head.
Let me dive in there quick. Like
all right.
Coolio, looks good to me. So first fish in the match, 18 pound, Mr. Calder, being put back by Cookie, giving it some time, and away she goes. Happy days. Cameraman the cameraman. They know exactly who's being video, that's why I was trying to get you to do it.
That out, mate.
I've only just turned it on, so you're alright.
That's cool, mate.
Tea lad today? They're working hard, the boys are working hard. I didn't even weigh it, it was under £10, £11 that one, so.
Doing alright, isn't he?
He's doing alright.
Good boy.
He's got
no
friends. Who?
Boy.
Hands in the pocket and everything.
Naughty boy.
I just want to get this on camera. He's actually got rods out. He's got rods out, so I'll capture this moment because it's quite. I know, he's put bait in and there's rods out and Roy is fishing. Anyone that knows Roy knows that this is a momentous moment. I may have to go around and see him. He might be ill if he's got rods out. He might not be well. Lewis. Is that nice? Yeah. Sorry.
Mind your fingers.
Wait.
Yeah.
A little bit less running around, please.
Okay.
Please, Alex. A little less running around, please.
Okay.
Alright.
Well, you have 9 sticks.
What's that, mate?
Well, you have 9 sticks to jump off.
Because David Moss, this is his motorbike number.
Names are you?
Bastard.
Oh, well done, Meg.
He'd love this, wouldn't he? Anybody else need the light up?
Yeah, for you.
Right, let's try this again. It's about 8:30 and I just done a load a bit to camera and then realised it was on, it hadn't recorded, it was on pause. Unbelievable. So I'm going to have to try and do all this again. I'm not, update basically of what's gone on, because I haven't done loads of video. I know this, I'm going to see if I can clean the camera lens because it is misty on there. Lots of special moments at this weekend. Well, say lots of special moments. Not really helping, is it? Right, Mossy weekend special anyway. But we've had a few special moments, one of them being last night. 100 Chinese lanterns. I say 100, 96 Chinese lanterns we let off. David's racing number, doing 222 might have been way too many. Some people may say the 96 was too many, but if you was here last night and watched everyone put them together and come together around a fire in between the lakes and send them off into the sky, into more or less a full moon, well, it was it's something you just don't forget. Emotionally, it was, you know, it was just crazy. It was happy. It was all the emotions rolled into one. Not only for the family, but for us, for all of us that are here, it was very special. As I said earlier, but hasn't recorded, I've got lots of people later to thank. Lots of this I wouldn't have got done without so much help from certain people that are, that not just only have helped me with this, but have helped me throughout the Crusaders and even personally, generally just absolutely top people. And the Crusader spirit that has gone on this weekend, not only from these people, but from everyone, has been absolutely amazing. The family, I think, have had a good time, Dawn and Steve and Rob. We all suffered the rain yesterday, a couple of hours of quite heavy downpours. The fog came in last night just after we'd done the lanterns, and it's been here all day. It's just clearing now with the sun, but it's a bright blue sky out there this morning, and everything's wet. There was frost on the ground. Fish have been caught. It's just been excellent. It's been a really good time. We have joint leaders. I don't know if that's come up on the last bit of video I did, but joint leaders at the minute. Neil Calder, Brian Collins, both have had 18 pound exactly fish, one a mirror, one a common. So we're going to see what happens. I don't know what I'm going to do with joint winners. I'm still not quite with it, I must admit. Obviously I'm not, if I didn't even start recording the last 20 minute talking I just did. So
You have to excuse, well, me, the footage. But it's become, it looks like it's going to be a lovely day. There's lots of people out there, up at the tea bar, poachers rest, having tea and breakfast, and mingling, chatting, laughter. Laughter's been constant all weekend. Like I say, it's just a shame it's a bit damp out there. It was yesterday. I'm on House Lake, sitting here on House Lake, so I'm in between the two lakes. Middle Lake's just over the road, but the grass is pretty long towards Middle Lake, and my trousers are pretty wet from walking over now. And I've had to sleep in them being wet, but and obviously we all got a bit wet during the old rain as well. But I will pop over there at some point. Yoda over there, Sean, Anthony Downs, Peter Lee's over there, Kev Moss, Tracy and Ken, and Becky as well. Little Alfie's over there, Martin Brown. So I will go over there at some point. I can't get too much wetter. My feet are soaked. They have been soaked for the last couple of days, which isn't good, I know, but it don't matter. It doesn't matter. I'm trying to remember what I put on the first bit of recording, or non-recording that I did, because I kind of got it all out, but it's not coming back to me now. So I've got raffle tickets to do today. I've got the, we'll do the raffle later. I need to sell, I know people want raffle tickets, so I need to do them. I didn't do none yesterday, it was quite wet, and just the fact that people were just enjoying being together and what have you. So today I'll be doing that. Obviously we'll do the presentation later. I want to do it so we can get it done by a reasonable time. Sean and his family, obviously the family are here, the Caroline and the kids, Megan and Lewis. But also, obviously the Moss family themselves, they're all travelled down together, and they're going to want to leave. I want them to be able to leave by 5 o'clock at the very latest, so at least they can get home at some kind of decent time. 4.5 hours, I think, 5 hours it took them to get here. So, you know, it's going to be a long journey for them. So I'd like to get, obviously the plan is to get it all done by sort of 4 o'clock, and then hopefully then they can sort themselves out and they can leave and get home decently at a good time to have a kip, and obviously a lot of them have got work tomorrow as well. So yeah, waking up, sorting myself out. I've had a cup of tea. I'm going to brush my teeth because it's badly needed. Hopefully there'll be a few more fish come out, and I'll try and do a bit of video today, maybe, hopefully as well Mr. Munch will be down, which I'm quite looking forward to, although he's going to get dirty, and I bathed him. I know if he's wandering around here he's going to want to see everyone, he's going to get muddy as hell, but that's alright, another bath on it for him, he'll love that. So yeah, I'm going to try and do some pictures, I'm going to try and do some more video. Like I say, very luckily we've got Lewis here again. He was here at the first match. He's pictured as the top of the Crusader group of all of us together. He's taken some stunning shots, especially last night with the lanterns and bits like that. He's also done some video for us as well, so I know at some point I will get a lot of that, and he'll let me sort of hopefully put it all into a song. I'll try and make a video, but it just, while I'm down here, yeah, I want to do video, I want other people to enjoy and see what we've done and pictures and that, but for me priority is the people that are here and the family being here and making sure everything goes okay. I'm not sure if I've done that, but the laughter and what's been going on and everyone being happy seems to be good, so yeah, I will try and do some video. I'm sure there'll be a bit of video of the raffle draw and the presentation and a few photos and that. Again, it'll probably all be Lewis's stuff. He's got the equipment, but he's also an excellent photographer. I mean, he knows his stuff, and they're going to be much better than what I could do. Who's this? Hello, mate. Is that Lewis's?
Yeah.
Top man, thank you, sir.
Were you videoing?
I am. I'm trying to catch up because I haven't done hardly any. Mr. Harper. Mr. Chef, who's been an absolute diamond once again. You're a good man. So let me put this
pause for now. Paul said he come round a minute ago. He said, "Oh, Rob was out cold, like." I was like, "Oh, he's just rung me. He's got a fishy."
There you go, mate.
9 o'clock, Sunday morning. Rob, who's had hard time in here, haven't you, mate? Yeah. You've had a few fish in here, but you got a fishy. We're going to have a little weigh. We'll get some falters as well. Oh yeah, I used the... Alright. 12, 10?
What do you reckon?
11?
11 bang on.
Oh, look at that. Well done, mate. Well, at least you've had one, haven't you?
I had one in the night, it's probably only
well. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, so you've had a bit of a sleepless one, have you?
Yeah.
Do you want a photo with it, mate, or?
Yeah,
get somewhere. Yeah, I'll come down to there then. Hopefully the light should be all right without. Yeah, where are my oatcakes? Yeah. Not a 20 then.
Bless it.
Yeah, that's all right.
You're all welcome though, mate.
Of course they are. You've had a few now, you doing all right, yeah?
Yeah,
you wish. Right, yeah, I was going to say, you wish it was about down to all the weights.
Yeah.
What's your rod? What we got common?
Just stand still. That's why she wears leggings now.
Well, I'll just do a few closer ones, bro.
Jessica. This isn't worth it. How would you out there?
Oh.
Cricket away crying about sizing. Really good.
Extended focus. We're trying to cut the
Alright,
it's perfect.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
Great. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Can I have a go?
386.
No one's got a ticket, we've got to check it against the 9.
Oh,
so that's number 1. Right, it's for Matthew Gow, who's obviously Bolton before and he's not here. Josh, come and choose an envelope. Actually, Alex, do you want to choose one of these envelopes?
It's not for you.
Yeah, you don't get it, I'm afraid, mate. Right? There's loads to choose from.
Yeah.
You can choose it. There's three and three. You've got these ones over here. You can choose any one you like. You sure? Yeah? Yeah, let me have a look. Oh, it's a set of radios that I actually have here from Sean, so it'll get sent off to him as soon as we get back. Alex, do I choose a ticket?
Yeah.
You reach? Can't reach. Stretch. You want that one? Sure. Oh. Sean Beardmore.
Yay!
Oh no! You printed them, so you know they want to look good.
Separate parts.
There's a
t-shirt or something
like
that.
Yeah, sort out
mate.
Hold on, before you go, you choose the next one. Let people know what we've got.
What was it?
A session pack.
Oh, shoot, babes.
Don't catch, though, that ain't good. Sorry, man, I couldn't help it. I couldn't help it.
5, 2, 5.
His eyes all swinging. That one? That's the one? That's the winning one. Blue ticket, 672. Yeah. Tracy Elliott.
Who is she?
Bad Trace. Get a choice, have a bit of luck. Anyone, call them over. Yeah, you have to stand and explain what it is to everyone.
£15
voucher.
Join it and buy
B&G tablet. Yeah, alright. Guys, point go.
Alex, I think you can move now.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Blue ticket, 599.
Yeah,
Tracy, you just chose your own ticket. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? She's going to share this one. Well, mate, I'm Trace. Choose a...
Come on, Rob, they're all white envelopes.
Did you buy any tickets though? There you go.
Yeah, I can read it. 20
legs.
Check it. What is it, Rob?
White, 237. It's from Mark Hedger. Again, not here today, but bought it before the
Baggins, come Meg, pick it.
You want to pick one, Meg? Come here, you can pick a price. So we'll put this ticket inside and we'll make sure he gets it, alright? So, any one of these envelopes. Not that one. No, I'm only joking. That one? So it's 5 kilogram or kilos of VNF from XL bait, so I'll make sure Mark gets that sent to him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Do you want to pick a ticket as well?
Sure. Yeah.
Have a dig around. No, you want that one? You want that white one?
White. Oh, I saw
you. Well then, Meg.
That's Matthew Gow again, who won one earlier. So, who's going to pick a card? You want to pick another one? Where's Lewis?
Lewis,
come here, mate. Pick an envelope for me, mate. Well, you wanted that, didn't you?
Not in the chair.
It's a good bag. I've got one lid left. Rubbish. Bait of bait and terminal packs, so I'll make sure we get both bits, I suppose. You're going to get a ticket, mate. No, you'll pick your dad's out.
You better do it, I'll just be grounded. Yeah.
White one again. 416. I'm going to sleep for a long time. It's like half 3 in the morning. Okay, that's Jason Whitlock again, bought before the match. So, what's the chooser prize for me? You are all had to go.
Fish.
And you work on the prize?
Come on,
any envelope, mate.
It's an effort, isn't it?
If I have to.
Yeah, I'll get paid for this.
You're choosing it for yourself.
So, Jason Whitlock's got a £50 voucher for bespoke decals, so they'll get sorted with him. You want to pick a ticket round? Sure, you're right with that, yeah? You look dodgy to me.
I'm not bad.
Go again.
Blue, I missed it.
White one still. Done two again. Get down deep. Get in there. Make sure you pick one. Is that one? Sure it's one. Singular. Right, 580 on a white.
Get a job.
Again, not here, I bought before the match. We have to pick a prize. Let's have a go.
You
want to have another go?
Jane, fella.
Jane?
I was going to
say
that
one's in there.
Do you want to pick a prize,
Jane?
Ben.
Ben. Ben. Ben.
Ben,
little one.
This one was donated by Dave Mossy. I'm sure a lot of you probably know him on the group. His son owns a pub in Greenwich and he donated a lunch for two down at the pub was going to be all paid for, so I'll make sure that gets passed on to Sam. Alright, big man, you choose one. Oh, you're looking at these. Dig deep, get right in there, have a fight mix up. Blue one? Blue, 183.
There you go.
You. I guess you better pick an envelope. Bet you enjoyed that, didn't you? Any envelope, mate. Oh, good, you get to read it out there, everyone.
Where's my address?
Rob Moss. Oh, we have a swap up there.
Right, sure, we've got a set.
Hey, big man, where you going?
I'm hit.
What?
Joshua?
9-9-5. That's like the last one.
Oh,
this is quite a weird one. Right, 998 is been won by Bubba Stanton. Now, Bubba is one of our American Crusaders who basically sent the money to just help with adding to the donations as such. He did say to me if he did win any bait or anything like that, he'd like it to go to one of the kids that may be here that are fishing or whatever. So hopefully we'll get a bait prize of some sort. who's going to choose a prize? Why do you want to do it for me while you're here? Are you going to fight it out or are you going to choose one together? Oh, can you work together?
Together!
Can you work together? That one? Yeah, both happy with that? It's a £15 voucher for bespoke bobbins. Now, I know he's not going to want me to send it to America and do it that way, so I'll contact him at some point and there will be a post or something on the group that maybe we'll give it to a young crusader and we'll get passed on that way, so I'll do something about that on the group. Oh dear.
Oh no.
Peter Lee.
Oh no.
Whatever I do with you is a menace, isn't it? It's
a cat, it's a can of Foster's.
No,
I'm
sorry.
No.
No,
I'm
sorry,
pal.
Good.
That's the movie one.
The only you must have sold it to him then.
We got to pick the nickname.
Yeah, Pete, you've got to pick his nickname as well, you know.
Five, six, seven.
Oh, I just need to sit down. But no, but there's a nickname now. He was there first. Oh, God.
Cookie. Alfie's got the hoodie, yeah?
Yeah.
Speak to him and.
Yeah, you got to pick the nickname, sorry.
David.
Gene Barlow.
He kissed her.
Not even here, right?
He tells you
about it. She don't know.
Thank you.